Hey guys, it's TownieSimBuilds here, and we are back again with another build challenge today. Now, today's build challenge is going to be something a little different, and I think there have been like variants of the same challenge, but I'm calling this the Shrinking Room Challenge. So what we're going to do is we're going to try and build a house in Sulani, but with each room is actually going to get thinner and thinner and thinner. So we're going to have six rooms in total. We're going to start with one as a 3x6, work our way down to 3x5, 3x4, 3x3, 3x2, and finally 3x1. Now the catch with this one is I actually have no idea which room is going to be which. So we're starting with a 3x6. I don't know if it's going to be a living room, a bathroom. We're just going to have to roll with it. So I have all the rooms written down here. I'm going to do this the old-fashioned way with like drawing names out of a hat. And for rooms, we have the bedroom, of course. We have the dining room. We have the living room, bathroom, kitchen, and study. All right, guys, and we are ready to draw our very first room. And the first room, which is going to be a 3x6, is the study area. So going into this, this is going to be a little weird, you guys. I'm going to try and build the room separately, and then we're going to kind of merge them together and try to make one cohesive house. So as a 3x6, this is what we're working with. 3, 4, 5, 6. It's a pretty small space, if I'm being honest with you guys. So these rooms are going to get pretty cramped. And I think in general, I would like this to be a home for at least one or two Sims. So hopefully a couple, but we really don't know what the bedroom is going to look like because this is already pretty small. But yeah, we're going to try to go with some kind of modern look. I really love modern style beach houses. And normally I go for this palette right here. It's the swatch from Island Living. And it's just a really nice wood. I really think it works. Maybe I overuse it a little bit, but I think we're just going to roll with it. Alternatively, we do have these swatches from Spa Day, which I actually think look pretty cool. So maybe I'm going to mix it up a little bit. And I think I'll start with these for flooring. Let's see. Keep it light. Keep it light. And we seriously need some lights. It's super dark in here. It's always time to throw down like one of these basic one of these basic ceiling lights just to get a little bit of a grasp on things. Now, unfortunately, I have no idea where these windows are going. I think I'll just try to put some, and I would like to do some full length windows as well. So I think I'll try with these. And for our study, I'm gonna hope that the door goes somewhere in this area. And then maybe just create a nice desk space towards the window front. So in general, like I said, I want this to be fairly modern. I want the color palette to be fairly light on the lighter side. So I'm going to try to match that the best I can. And perhaps I'll just do some natural wood furniture. I think we'll go tiny living. I think this is going to fit the look I'm going for. Hopefully. So we have this matching. We'll get a computer. Kind of don't mind that. This is from the Get to Work pack and it does look pretty sleek. So I think it's a pretty solid option. Can I find something with lighting? I think I'd like a good floor lamp. Ooh, this is really cool, you guys. I actually just got the Spa Day pack and I'm so late, but at least when I got it, I do have the refresh. So I think this is really cool. This could be a really cool divider. So I think I'm going to use it. And what I'm actually going to do is I'm going to create more of a office space on the left. And maybe there's like a little nook where there could be like an artist space, if that makes sense. I'm thinking I would like something like this. I know this is just base game, but I would like something that's not too obtrusive and kind of hangs over, if that makes any sense. I'm like itching to use a lot of the new content from Spa Day because I just got that. You guys were in my polls. You guys were suggesting what packs I would get next. So I think it's time. I think it's time, you guys. I can try to start bringing in some new elements, keep it kind of light, natural, a little bit minimalistic. We do have this rug. I think this is pretty interesting. It looks like it's made out of wood. I don't know how to say that. I'm going to mispronounce that and it's going to sound like a bad word, so I'm not going to do that. But this is the Spa Day rug. I'm going to see if something like this could work. I'm always overwhelmed with rugs because there are so many options. I know there's a lot of good stuff with City Living. I think I want to keep it fairly light though, and I don't think I want anything too crazy. So we're just going to have to see how that goes. I think I might just go with the one from Tiny Living. I think it just fits the look. I think what I'll do is actually create a little bit of a bookcase area. So we have this from Seasons. It's really, really big. This is actually not bad. I really like this bookcase from Snowy Escape. And then of course we can always add a little bit more clutter in this area too, but what to put on it. I don't really know. I don't really know, you guys. Let's see if we can take advantage of it. Man, you guys, it's a struggle. It's a struggle sometimes. Sometimes I really have no idea what to use for clutter, and I'm just kind of like flouncing about looking for something, you know what I mean? And I think this one's fine. I'm just gonna go base game and do this little music player here. This plant is from the paranormal stuff pack, and I think it actually works fairly well. I'm gonna size it down just a little bit, situate it there. And yeah, I think I like it. This is a vibe. This room has a vibe. Maybe we'll just go a little bit of desert luxe with this one. I normally don't use kits because I'm not really a fan of them, but this one is free and yeah, it just works. But in terms of the other space, I think I will go with an artist space, and maybe, just maybe, I can get in more windows, but ultimately, I think it's going to depend on where this room actually is going to go. So I'll do this, I'll put one of these down here. I do want some kind of end table, because if you are painting, you definitely need something to put your stuff down. So let's see if we can find something that works. That is kind of funky, I'm not gonna lie, you guys. I like that it is, yeah, I like that it's a little bit more abstract. So I think that would be fitting here. Something like this, just like that. Yeah, I think that works. I just gotta, it's a lot of guesstimating, you guys. Like you really can't figure out how to precisely like move object, place things in. You kind of have to guess a little bit and hope for the best, but I think that's sitting correctly. Okay, here we go. Just gonna go simple and just do a pencil holder and I guess just a notebook. It's, you know, it's not like the most fitting thing for an artist, but I think it's gonna have to do. I'm gonna try to repurpose this lamp again because I do like this. This is definitely an artist style lamp, especially if you have like a still life setup. I'm not sure, you guys. This is looking funky. I don't think lights behind your easel makes sense. You're probably gonna get some weird shadows. So I think what I'm just gonna do is I'm just gonna use this light. I'm gonna scale it down again and just put it neatly overhead. I think that's probably our best solution. That could be really cool. I think I'll put one here. Whoa! This, not sure if I'm feeling it. Keep it with a nice kind of like fern style plant. And I think this is a pretty good point for our study area, and I think I will then move on to the next room. All right, guys, so the next room is going to be a 3x5. So we're gonna get a little bit smaller, and hopefully this is not like a really bad room to get. And we have the dining room. All right, dining room. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so this is the room we have to work with. I'm just going to pull the same woods again. I will also take these windows, and I think for the dining room, I actually want a very, very large wall of windows kind of looking out onto the ocean. I think that'd be really cool. But yeah, again, it's going to depend on how things play out, what the other rooms are going to look like. But this is it so far. Now, I do want lighting that is definitely a little bit more elegant. And honestly, I do like, whoa. Okay, we can't even dine here. We can't even walk by, so can't use that one. Now, the entry point of this room is going to be a little tricky. I think I will kind of hug it close to the wall a little bit because I foresee the door being somewhere along this wall. So I'm going to play it safe. Just not really sure on the pattern because I think it is a little louder than I would have wanted to use. Okay, yeah, these are really crazy. So I think this is fine. What I'm going to do now is find the dining table. We can do something a little glassy. That could be interesting, but we don't really have a lot of good color, so it's a little bit sad. Let's see, round table. I don't think it really works here. You know what, guys? I think we're going to go with more of a Japanese theme. So I think this one works great. Ooh, these are pretty interesting. These are also from Spa Day, and they should also function as dining chairs. So I think I'll use these. Yeah, this room is going to be lit up, you guys. I feel like this room probably, you know, it probably could have been a greenhouse, if that makes sense. I really like this piece. It's some kind of stones from Spa Day with a small plant, but leaves kind of a strange shadow. So I think I'm going to do, what looks zen? I'm thinking zen right now. I think that's probably the way to go. I do love this. Can we get it in a lighter palette? Lighter swatch? Whoa! Not the table. All right, I'm thinking we may use that one base game rug. I think we can actually make it work. And to be honest with you guys, I actually don't mind this rug at all. I think it has its purposes, even though it's base game. And then, like I said, I do want some different plants along the wall as well. So I'm going to see what we have here. That is also not bad. I love, like, larger... I love the larger plants as well. It has a lot of like palm fronds sticking up, so I think that fills the space. Decisions. Ooh, we had this too. This looks like a deviled egg, right? Is that what you call them? Deviled eggs? Poached eggs? Interesting. Okay, maybe more bamboo. I think more bamboo might be the option. So I'll use this one here. I'll kind of keep it similar to the other room, so bringing in some of the same elements. All right, so I think that just about does it on the dining room. I think, like I said, I really don't know how the door situation is going to work out. So hopefully if we do have room later on, we can go back and add like some paintings and stuff. But anyways, we're going to be on to our next room, and this one is going to be a 3x4. So we're starting to get a little bit smaller now, and our next room shall be... All right, our next room is the bedroom. Okay, this is not too bad. We have a... Yeah, I already forgot. We have a 3x4 bedroom now, so let me get that drawn out. All right, so we have 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so I think we're in luck. I think we can still fit in a double bed. So I definitely want to do that. I definitely want this to be for a couple. And yeah, this house is going to be weird, you guys. I'm trying to like think of the layout right now, and... Maybe we're going to figure out a little bit. But again, I love these windows. I like having like a big open view. Maybe it's a little bit EA of me, but I think we're just going to roll with the windows because I do like them. So let me find something that works. And we don't. I think I can do the Murphy bed, but it's a little bit of a squeeze. You know, I actually don't mind this little touch of blue. I think it adds just a little bit of something else to the room. But yeah, I am a little bit concerned about how squashed things might get. So we do have a little bit of a view. I feel like this bedroom is going to be a little sad, but we just don't have enough space. I'm thinking the door is going to be somewhere over here. So that's what I'm planning for. But we do need a dresser of some kind. So let me look at options for this. This one is huge. I love it, but it is definitely on the bigger side, and I don't think this is very accessible, but I think we will have to go tiny living on this one. So I think perhaps something like this, kind of in the corner. I'm going to neutralize the colors a little bit because they just don't really go. So having that white and that soft wood tone. Yeah, I could do a TV on that, but I think it's going to look a little weird. But let's do it for the heck of it. Let's just do it. We could do a smaller TV like this. Oh, it actually snaps. Okay. it's a little bit dramatic, if I'm being honest with you guys. It's kind of soaring high on the stand. But I think I want to roll with it. I think I want to roll with it because I know that if I was in this room, I would at least want the television there. So I think that's fine. Okay, so this is not really, there's not really much fitting in here. I think I'm just going to create another sitting area again. So I'll probably use this just to add a little bit of something in the space. We do have more bamboo again. I don't know if it's getting a little bit repetitive, but honestly, I think it kind of fits with the theme, so maybe I'll do this. What I can also do is actually put a mirror, so I'm actually thinking I can use the one from Parenthood. Okay, not bad, but it's not quite what I'm after. You know, they say if you have a small space, mirrors are your best friend. It gives you the illusion that your room is bigger than what it is. So I think this is actually fine. I think I'm going to use this. And like I said, I don't really know how this room is going to situate, so I'm going to leave this wall blank, and hopefully we'll figure out something later on. Okay, so I think that's it for our little tiny cozy bedroom. And you know what? Let me see if I can add a rug. I do want some kind of rug. You know, I kind of don't mind it on the whole room. It may not be everyone's cup of tea, but yeah, I think it's interesting. I think I'm going to roll with it, you guys. I think it's nice having a nice, very lush rug underneath your feet, you know, especially in your bedroom. So I think we're going to roll with that. So if I'm not mistaken, the next room is going to be a 3x3. So now we're getting really small. I'm kind of scared, to be honest with you guys, because yeah, there's still some very important rooms that are left. But let's see, the next one is the bathroom. Okay. So the bathroom, we have 3x3. That's actually very doable. I'm usually not a huge fan on huge bathrooms. So I think this will work out fine. So we have 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Okay, cool. So that is our bathroom, which is not bad at all. So for the bathroom, I'm almost thinking I can do something a little bit different. I'm just going to borrow the swatches just for getting kind of the main elements down. I'm thinking we could try something a little different if we do want like a sort of tile on this room instead. And then definitely we cannot have super large windows looking in. That's just not really going to go down very well. So I'm thinking something like this. I'm going to try to situate it somewhat where the other windows are. I think these align somewhat. And then, like I said, I want to try something a little different. I think it's nice to mix up the... not the flooring. It's nice to mix up the flooring, and it's nice to mix up the wallpaper a little bit, because we do want this space to feel a little bit more unique. Ooh, I love this. This is from Spade. Where have you been all my life? We are in luck, you guys. Okay, perfect. All right. So I'm fine with it being matchy-matchy. I think it's going to work. Again, I don't really know where the door is going to be, and that's usually the bummer here. But I'm going to keep it spacious just in case we have to move things around. Ooh, that's cool. I don't think I've ever used this one. This is the bathtub from the Seasons pack, and it definitely fits the feel. I love the stone with the earth elements, and it does feel actually like a spa. All right, countertop situation. I think I'm going to pull the ones from Island Living and just go be a little bit lighter like this. Hold the phone. Okay. Bye-bye. Bye-bye. This is just too lovely here. So I think I will take one of these. What do we use? There's this one, but it's very techy. I don't know. It kind of breaks the feel a little bit. Yeah, I think we'll just go with Tiny Living. I think that one's fine for now. It just doesn't scale right. We might have a scale problem, you guys, because I don't know what's going to fit. There is this one, but we did already use it in the office, so... not quite sure, because it does fit. Oh, it does fit fairly well, but we do clip again. clipping. Just don't make life easy, my friend. I'm going to put a towel rack over here. I do love this one also. This is kind of a cluttered shelf from Tiny Living, and it just works really great. Again, we don't really know where the doors are, so I'm just going to keep this side clear, and hopefully we can connect it. Definitely need some blinds, because we don't need anybody seeing our bits and pieces. No, we don't. Those definitely feel a little bit more commercial, so maybe something like this. This? Maybe this one, you guys. Ooh, that shadow, though. Ain't gonna happen. We have, like, this very modern, minimalist zen, and then we have, like... yeah. We have these weird curtains. They feel like, sorry grandmas, but I feel like this is probably something closer to what you'd have in your home. It just doesn't really fit the vibe, unfortunately. We could use these from Cottage Living, which again offer a little bit of closure, but I just don't know if they fit the feel. I think they do give enough privacy, and we can neutralize them at least, so I think we're gonna go with that. So I think we are set with the bathroom, and then our next room is now a 3x2. So we're getting really skinny, and we only have these two rooms left. So I'm gonna reach in and see what we have. We have the living room. Oh man, we have the living room, you guys. Okay, so this is a 3x2 living room. This is pretty small, but I think it's going to have to do. So here we go, 3x2. Now, I will return to probably a lot of the older swatches I used, and I'm going to save these swatches for the kitchen area. Yeah, so I'll do this. Guys, what are we going to do in this little box? I have no idea. We definitely need some windows, that's for sure, because this is just a very crammed spot. So I'll do this. I'm going to do my best to cram in a TV and... a couch. I think that's the best I can do here, because we just don't have a lot of room. It's not looking good, you guys. We just don't have space. Maybe something like this. I'll take it from Tiny Living, perhaps. Like that. Okay, thankfully it has neutral tones, so that'll do. That works pretty well. Yeah, it's gonna be really close to the TV. I think you're going to be blinded by the lights. Yeah, your Sims are gonna be blinded by the lights, but I think they can get in here. I think they can. Just gonna scooch this in a little tiny bit more. So something like this, kind of like a good old PS5. So something like this, so you can game, you can watch TV. probably gonna put in some kind of painting here. Let's see what we can do. Better, you know what, I'm gonna save it. I'm gonna save it for when we combine the house, so we'll wait on that. I do want a small rug though, because it is really, really close quarters here. I think what I wanna do is actually take the fur rug. I do love this one a lot. So let me see that. Where are, there we go. It's like playing a game of Operation. You're gonna like, whoa, really careful with the hand there. Okay, so here we go. Here is our rug. Yeah, I think I'll take a break from the other plants, but I will use this base game one. And then maybe just one from Spa Day. Like this. Something like this. Keep it nice and simple because we just don't have... we don't have a lot of room here. And that is about it for our living room. And I already know the last room, and this is going to be so sad, you guys. But if you did not... if you did not remember, the last room is the kitchen. The last room is the kitchen. So, 3x1 kitchen. This is fun. Yeah. This room is going to be hard, you guys, because it needs some kind of archway. It needs some kind of archway. Otherwise, this room is just not going to be functional. So I do have to like work with the room in that way. So everything will, everything for the kitchen will still be contained within this room. But I do need to give this some kind of large archway or even multiple, because it's unfortunately just not going to be usable. And yeah, this is going to be the saddest kitchen ever, if I'm being honest with you guys. I'll just put those there. So for the kitchen, I'm just probably going to use the stuff from Snowy Escape. Try to match the tones the best I can. So we'll do probably a lighter wood, I think. I'm actually going to break this wall because I can't see, you guys. I can't see. So I think something like this. I think it's fairly cohesive with the rest of the house. We can do these from Jungle Adventures, which is not too bad. Not too bad. I think maybe we'll keep with them. This is like New York style apartments, you know, super, super small. I've actually seen ones that have been worse than this, where I think it's literally like a mini fridge and then a hot plate, I think. And if you're lucky, you get a very small, just basic metal sink. So this is not by any means too far-fetched, but still it's pretty tight. It's a pretty tight space. Oh, this is kind of fun too. This is also from Jungle Adventures, so I actually think something like this could be nice. It kind of has a stone quality, much like the tiled wall, so I don't think that's a bad option. All right, so we do have all of our rooms complete, and now now the crazy part is actually making it all fit together. So I think logically, I do want to start with the dining room. I think it gives us the biggest point of entry that we may need in this house. So I'm going to try to drag it down, probably somewhere over here. The kitchen has to go off of it somehow, so I'm thinking it can actually go like this. Something like this along the wall. It's going to be a little weird, but I think you guys are going to have to bear with me on this one. So here's the kitchen. Again, the kitchen is not accessible in this way. So I can put doors, but again, it's going to be blocking it. So let me try and find some kind of archway that hopefully can work. There's this one, but it's way too big. There is this one, but then we do have our other stuff cut off, so I don't really know how that's going to work. I think what I can do, though, is just kind of just delete this, and we have to accept this as the kitchen. Like, we know it's like the 3x1 room. There's just not really a clean way. There's not a clean way for me to cut it out. I think that's the problem. And maybe in a different pack, there may have been like some kind of archway I could use, but yeah, it's just not really happening, you guys. So I think we will have to leave it cut out. I'm gonna take this room and probably move it over here. No, maybe the study goes in back. Study goes in back. Okay. Bedroom. Probably go over here-ish. Let's see. Can we do it like this, you guys? It's kind of coming along. Okay, so there's that. I feel like the study needs to be kind of a connecting room for a bunch of stuff. So that's gonna be a little bit tricky. It's not bad. I think I can make it work a little bit. The living room is... yeah, the living room is really funky. The bathroom should connect probably to the study. like this. Okay, I think we have one window still. Okay, that's not bad. And then the living room. This is hard, you guys. There are no hallways, so this is really funky. The living room can probably go here. going to be like an extension of the study area. So now what I'm going to do is actually going to go in and clean this up. And I do want this to connect in a somewhat logical way. What I can do is actually create, I can actually create columns, and then I can have the spandrels kind of going across it. So that's kind of like a workaround if I want to keep the integrity of the room, if that makes sense. But I do have to find some things that will work. So I'm thinking just a simple wood like this. You know, this is actually not looking too bad, you guys. I think I just need different columns. Something a little bit more modern. And yeah, I think this is actually not looking too bad. So I'm gonna move things over a smidgen. And I think it'll work. I think it is workable with this little kitchen area. And I think this will have to be our main entry point, which I'm honestly not too sad about it. I think it looks fairly decent, but we do have to give it a proper roofing job, if you will. The roofing is not too bad. It's not too bad, you guys. I think this little intersection is odd. You know, maybe I could play around with it a little bit more, but I think it's not looking too bad, if I do say so myself. So I think that is that. Just make the rooms a little bit different, just a little bit of something extra, you know what I mean? Like something a little bit bold. More of a brown door. We have a clear door, maybe something simple like this. So we can probably match it with the other windows, so that's not too bad. Let me see if I can perhaps make some kind of wooden deck. I think that could be really interesting. And I will take some wood here. Maybe a lighter wood, perhaps something like this. Can I surround the house? Maybe I can. So something like this. Gonna kind of drag it all the way around like this. Just so it feels like the house isn't exactly sitting on sand, if that makes any sense. Because it is pretty, yeah, it's pretty low on the ground. All right, then let me see if I can add in a little bit of greenery here. I'm gonna use the terrain paint tool. Probably just add in a little bit of better soil. So we do need that in our lives, something like this. Yeah, I really love a lot of these like really fun little spiky desert plants. I think they work really great. So I will use those. Just a few touches here and there, and then adding in a little, perhaps just a little tiny bit of fencing in. Just like this, keeping those plants in check. Maybe I'll just throw in, you know, a good pool for the sake of it. Just throw in a little pool out here, probably something like this. I'll probably just have them over here. We're kind of running out of room, so I think this is fine. Just so you guys can get a little bit of an idea of how pretty much this house could be laid out, if you do wish to recreate it, because I don't think this is going on the gallery. I definitely use a lot of different packs, but yeah, I think it actually came out not too bad. It came out not too bad for the criteria. The criteria was hard, at least like in my opinion, it was definitely tricky. But yeah, I think this is pretty much it. This is more or less the challenge itself. I just kind of quickly pieced together a home with all of these shrinking room sizes. And like I said, I think this is pretty much the whole build itself. So I did try to connect it the best I could. And yeah, I think it was definitely fun. It was definitely challenging. And obviously this is just a quick look inside. We do have our dining room here. That is the main entry point. We do have the really tiny 3x1 kitchen here that I kind of made open by using the spandrels and the columns. So definitely still wanted to stick within the rules. And then of course, going over here, we have the full on study area. So this area is quite large, but we do have an art station and we do have a computer desk as well. We have our little bedroom over here that can sleep two Sims. So that is still pretty cozy. Got some plants, paintings, and a dresser and TV. We have a very luxurious minimalistic bathroom over here, also accessible for guests. And then we have this super tiny living room that has enough for a TV, a console, and a couch. So yeah, I think this was quite fun. Like I said, this lot, if I had more time, I probably would be furnishing a little bit more, but hopefully, you know, the end result is more or less a solution. It's a solution for all of these weird, crazy rooms that I had to clump together. Like I mentioned, unfortunately, this is probably not going to be on the gallery itself. But as always, I hope you guys had fun. I hope you guys probably got inspired to do some of your own challenges or mix it up a little bit. As always, thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you had a lot of fun doing this, and I will likely catch you in the next video. And of course, just like all my other videos, this has been TownieSimBuilds signing off. Thank you so much for watching, guys.